Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So, hi there. Hi. Christian, can I call you Christian? Okay.
Yeah, yes, yes, yes.
Okay.
I'd rather prefer to call me Christian than Gérard because this is my name.
Okay.
So let's do that.
Yes. What drew you to the project? What made you come on board?
I wrote it, and I said it's a very good company because there is behind a real subject of today, subject which is quite deep, but the movie is always funny. And the character is fantastic because he's very hypocrite. So there is big default to play. So I jump into it for that reason, for that main reason, and for other one too. But I think the writer, which is the writer Mr. Claude Guy Laurent, is always very interested by what's happening in the world, in Europe right now, and he wants to make comedy with it, which is a very good challenge. I love that. Because I was very fond of Italian comedies of the 70s, where they use the reality, the real world, and they make people laugh about it. And it is the same kind of challenge we wanted and he wanted to do with that movie. So it was very easy for me to decide to do it. Then we have to do it.
Well, could you please describe your character, Jean Etienne, for us a little?
I think it's a very... when they wrote me Mr. Claude, he was a very conservative part of France. This one is very province center of France. And this one is really Parisian, very much in Paris. He's a progressist guy, very fond of media, very fond of himself, giving lessons to everybody, and to put him inside of a situation, so Romanian coming inside of his wealthy house to stay in his garden, it's a nightmare for him and his wife. And so it was very funny to have that character confronted to that situation.
Everybody is being sort of criticized and made fun of, and the movie touches, as you said, on very difficult themes such as xenophobia or even social... commitment and integration. How important do you think is humor for these kinds of, well, dangerous sort of topics? Or to
I
look
think
at it
each time you make people laugh of a default of a character, you take a distance with that default. So if you share that default, of course you it will help to change a little bit. So I think comedy is very important in front of that big subject, because some people said, oh, you can't laugh on anything, which is, I think, very strange point of view for the artist, and in a way, not very efficient, because if you are making a very boring movie about that, nobody is going to change really, because the point of view of everybody is not going to change. I'm not saying that comedy is changing the world, but in a way, when you make people laugh to somebody who is really hypocrite or really in default or really in fear in front of a situation like that, you probably helps.
So how did you prepare for your role? Was there anything that you found specifically important to portray?
I think the hair of the guy was very important. That was one of the most important things I tried to do. It was a big challenge, and so when I found that, I think the guy was okay. He's very fond of himself, so he has something very special, so you can laugh at him.
Okay, so
that was a very good clue for me to open the character. It's a joke and not a joke, it's half and half.
Do you think there is any such thing as unselfish social commitment?
In a way, yes. Yeah, I think so. Jean Etienne is a man of image, so he will use everything. Even if he's saying the contrary. For his son, I think it's a little bit different. I think he's really involved. So what's going to happen after? I don't know. We'll see.
Do you know what you would have done in Jean Etienne's situation?
Call the police. I think I will be absolutely. It's a kind of, well, something like that happened to me in Corsica when people very angry and very mean came in my house, and so I was not very pleased by that. But they were violent, which is not the case with Babic.
What do you think a well, a character such as Erwan comes into the picture? What kind of role does he have?
I think the writers, they wanted to, the director and the writer, they wanted to have the main character, because he is the main character, because he thinks to the trick, he invented trick, and he was not a Romanian. So it means that we share all the defaults everywhere, and so it was not a cliche of the from the Romanian to think the guy is on TV, he's saying he's very open to accept everybody in his house, so we are going to jump there. So they didn't understand very well, and they said, what does he say? And the guy, Erwan, think of the trick.
You've already worked with Philippe on Monsieur Claude und seine Töchter.
Is it he and his daughter?
Yes. Okay. Well, what do you like about working with him?
I like the script is writing, first of all. So the scripts are very good, and when I'm is directing, is quite precise on one side, and on the other side lets you free of add a few things and to play. And he's a very good client of comedies, which is very important, because if you don't have somebody behind the camera who is laughing to what you're doing, it's difficult to play.
I'm from an internet site that's called the Movie College, and we're sort of an online platform for everybody interested in film, and most of all people wanting to learn about film. So I have a more general question also for you. What does your ideal collaboration with a director look like? Is there anything you would specifically wish for?
Yeah, I think everything is starting from the script. If you are, if you have the same sense of humor, if you are laughing over the same things, and especially when you're reading a script, you will find a way to play and to have a good collaboration with the director. And so you have to. The script is everything for me. Story. It's very, very important. Of course, directing is adding things. I'm not saying that directors are not a very important part. All the part in cinema is editing, directing, writing. But this is the three important part. So you to have a good collaboration, you have you have to have a very good and very important sense of humor, common sense of humor, during the three parts, on the script, when you're shooting, and when the director is editing. Because if he's not in the rhythm of the way you are acting for the editing, he's going to destroy the movie. It's very simple to destroy a movie in editing. So the three parts are totally important. In say 30%, 30%, 30%, same. Equal.
Okay, and they need to understand each other, have a sort of common sense.
You have to share, really, a point of view on a lot of things,
okay.
Even in life. Mm. You have to laugh of the same things in a restaurant, looking to somebody or a couple having an argument somewhere, and if you laugh at the same thing, it's going to match. Otherwise, it's difficult. If you have to intellect, to think, to explain too much, if you're not on the instinct, It's very difficult. Very difficult. It can happen and can make good movies, but it's difficult.
Do you have any tips for, you know, other actors at the start of their careers? Anything you want to encourage them with, or any?
It's an extraordinary. It's an extraordinary business. Fantastic. I can understand everybody, all the young generation, they want to jump into that career, but there is something very provocative that Gérard Depardieu is saying sometimes. He's saying that business make you con, make you not fool,
stupid,
make you stupid. And that is quite true. So it's an extraordinary business. But the way people afterwards are looking at you when you are successful, very dangerous. So try to do it. Try to do the business. Don't try to be famous. That's the most important part. And very often you meet some young people, and sometimes I ask them, do you like to play? or do you want to be famous? If you don't like to play, don't do it.
Well, last but not least, what would you like people to take away from the movie?
That's life is complex. The world is absolutely open, so we are going to be mixed. So we have to be confronted to that kind of situation, and we have to deal with it. So we can't close the door, even if it is difficult. But you don't have to deny that it is difficult. That's all.